The Korea U.S. Air Quality Mission, or KORUS-AQ, is a joint field study between NASA and the Republic of Korea, aiming to advance the ability to monitor air pollution from space. The campaign will assess air quality across South Korea using observations from aircraft, ground sites, ships, and satellites to test air quality models and remote sensing methods. But before the teams can get ready to head to Korea, there's a great deal of preparation that needs to happen, including integrating dozens of science instruments onto NASA's DC-8 and King Air aircraft. The team at NASA Armstrong has spent this month preparing each aircraft with a suite of sensors, probes, and hardware.
Do side and side, whichever one you want to do. Get the two sides.
Start to finish on the upload. The instruments will come in from the experimenters. We'll stage them and get them organized. They'll take them into a laboratory, put them together if they need to assemble their stuff in the laboratory. We'll inspect it prior to being installed on the airplane, integrated into the aircraft, to make sure that it's able to fly. And then we go on, start in the front, and start loading the instruments into the aircraft front to back. A little prior to that, we will, if you notice, we've got a lot of probes on the aircraft. The probes will get installed first. There's quite a variety of different probes that have to go into the ports of the windows. This particular upload, we're probably in the third or fourth week of our upload. It's a very large, for us, upload. There's 26 experiments on board, and each one of them has to go on separately. We treat them as each one's a separate entity, so getting them all sorted out is really quite the challenge. After all the equipment's installed in the airplane, we usually will leave the experimenters alone so they can play with their toys and make sure that everything's working. Once the airplane is ready for flight, we'll take it out and we'll do what we call a shake flight, which is just to verify that all the instruments that have been installed, that we don't have anything loose, moving around, causing any problems, verifying again that the airplane is capable of flying and doing what we expect it to do. The difference between this aircraft and other aircraft is the fact that we do have up to 50 sometimes, civilians. I mean, these people are from all over the globe. They're trusting us to provide them with a safe airplane where all they got to worry about is doing their science.
Not a big deal, Dan, but you got a couple cables that could use a little bit of security.
This is the hardest working crew that I've seen. I've had the privilege of working with. It's a hand-built load. Every single time we put these things on, it cannot get done without the crew that we've got working under me, and I'm privileged to have them work for me. I don't think we could do it without them.